Okay, now let's get back to the wheel. And if I was to cut the circle in half like this, then the top half people, they tend to be very relational. They're relationship oriented. Does that describe you? The bottom half, they tend to be more task or project oriented. They're more comfortable with projects than they are with people. Now, I would like to give you a few hints to be able to help you place yourself where you are. Let me cut this circle one more time like this. Okay, so the other half, they tend to be very spontaneous and impulsive. And this half over here, they tend to be planned. You know, they're good planners, they like planning, and they tend to be more systematic in their lifestyle. Now let me cut the circle one more time this way. Okay, now again, that half, they tend to be extroverts, they tend to be leaders, they have leadership qualities. Whereas this half over here, they tend to be introverts, and they're very content to be followers. Now this should help you and give you some clues about where exactly you fit. Now for myself, I am right there. As you see in the slide over there, you know, for me, according to my giftings, number one would be the encourager, number two would be the giver, and number three would be compassion. So I'm right there between, let's say, 11 o'clock and 3 o'clock on the clock over there. Okay, encourager, giver, and compassion. Now what I would like to ask you, my friend, is where do you find yourself? So what I would like you to do is to take the fourth page of the questionnaire that I gave you, and you see the wheel, the circle over there, and fill in that circle your own profile. So see, my profile looks like this. Number one is the encourager, number two is giver, number three is compassion. Now take a few minutes and fill up your own profile. We are only concerned with the top three, that connect, that relate to you the best. And the remaining four, they can be less, but we're not so much concerned about that. So take a couple of minutes and make your own profile based upon this little graph over here. Thank you. So you see, my friend, that God has created you with a certain personality, and He's given you specific spiritual gifts. He's placed you here in this particular time and place to accomplish a divine assignment or mission that only you can do best. Now what happens if you choose not to discover your mission or your goal in life? Well, you know, God's will be done, right? He's God, His will be done. But you may lose your reward. So the initiative is upon us to discover what is my mission in life with God's help, and then to start walking down that path. Because I tell you, there is nothing more satisfying or more fulfilling in this life than doing the will of God. That is what we were created for, and that gives you the maximum fulfillment, the maximum satisfaction. Once again, Bishop T.D. Jakes, he says this, that if you cannot figure out your purpose, figure out your passion, just follow your passion. What is it that really drives you? Because your passion will lead you right into your purpose. Now, with this understanding of who you are and what exactly are your drives, you're well on your way to fulfilling your calling. So begin today. There are some clues to help you recognize your mission. When people give you a heartfelt thanks, when they say, "Oh my goodness, you know, when you walked into my hospital room, I felt like the Lord Jesus walked into my room and encouraged me." Or when somebody says that when you explained this very difficult subject to me, I felt like finally I had found the answer after years of struggling. So when you get these kind of responses of people, understand that you may have hit upon your calling or your ministry. You may be well on your way. When you are so enthusiastic about doing something that you would gladly pay out of your pocket to have it done, then you know you have hit upon it. Okay, something that you are so passionate about that you're willing to spend money and make sacrifices to do that, even if nobody helps you, nobody supports you, nobody pays you to do it. And then here's another third clue. Supposing you suddenly receive an inheritance, and now you have all the money in the world for all your needs for your entire lifetime, and even for your kids. Okay, now what would you do with your time for the rest of your life? Let's say that you already gone on a round the world cruise, and you've built a big house, and your kids are taken care of, and you still have so much of life left, You still have so much of time left. What would your thoughts be? What would you like to do for humanity, for mankind? That may be a very big clue to which, what is God's calling in your life. But you have to start. You have to start sometime. And perhaps today might be the best place for you to start. Because like that old Chinese proverb says, journey of 1,000 miles begin with first step.